Ross it. What's that? Who there? Whoa.
Hey guys, it's Callaway. Hope everyone's doing well. In an effort to try to get this crispy video that you see behind me, we're experimenting with some new settings and a new player called Riverside. And unfortunately, the video did not record for this next episode. But we have Taylor's video and the audio sounds crispy, so we still wanted to make sure we played it. In the meantime, we'll just throw up a graphic and we'll be back in episode 37 with video on my side. Thanks. Enjoy the show. I'd love you to dive into like the inception story because I'm curious and I'm sure a lot of people are like, you know, given that you've pursued other things, were you just looking for something that worked? And when you found this kernel, you were like, let's double down? Or do you have like a specific tie to this particular problem? And either way is completely fine, but I'd love to get your perspective on that.
So a few different things. One, all three of us co-founders have always learned languages growing up. I have 10 years under my belt Spanish, but all I have to show for it is Donde está la biblioteca. Like, why did I take 10 years? But that's all I remember. And that's Spanish 101 for so many people. And I know Portuguese fluently. It's what I'm learning with Toucan also. But just learning languages, traveling, culture, education has always been something that we wanted to work on. And like, how do we crack this? Because the idea that you could spend 10 years learning something but not remember it, or like buy something for $1,000 and it just sits on a shelf and you don't really learn. Like, was there a way to crack this? And we just had this initial idea of like, let's layer on top of behaviors, but also let's test and talk to users. So V1 of Toucan was, you can imagine the word the being translated every single time on your webpage. Like in Spanish, that was it. Terrible user experience.
Yeah, they're like, I don't like this.
So bad, we were laughing, but we got it in front of people in coffee shops, like, hey, what do you think? This is our magic here. Like, what are you thinking? And everyone was like, this is so cool. And we're like, if this is terrible and it's cool, like there's something here for us to keep building hypotheses, proving things right or wrong, and just testing and iterating. And honestly, as we kept doing that, the idea got bigger. We're like, okay, there's something massive here. Like, this could be an iconic company.
Yeah, well, it's interesting. And I was listening to a couple of your other interviews. I don't think Toucan's like a learning language company. I think it's a learning company. And like, it's easy to see, like, you know, let's say financial education was something you wanted to tackle. You're reading an article and then, you know, similar to how like certain sites have words highlighted and you could see the definition, but there's a way to build that much more dynamically with what you guys have shown. So it's super fascinating. Is that kind of the direction you feel like you're going past languages?
For sure. Like right now we're a small team, so we're laser focused on languages. But in the back of our mind, we have, okay, as we attack other content verticals later down the line, how does this like quiz or this mini game or these like hover for mores transfer over to other content verticals so that we are able to like grow into that big, massive vision?